Hello everyone, this is Direwolf20, and welcome to episode 55 of Direwolf20's Let's Play series. Last episode, I went on a hunt for a very specific item. This guy right here, the Division Sigil. This thing can really typically only be found in a couple locations. Usually it's found in dungeon chests. However, you can also get it, as we saw last episode, from the Wither. Now, there's a complicated activation ritual which we need to perform in order to get this thing to be useful. Because right now, it's in an inactive state. You can't do anything with it right now, except activate it. And it's telling me right here, sneak right click on an enchanting table for more details. So let's check out how we're going to activate the Division Sigil. What we can do with it, what we can use it for. There's going to be a bunch of different things we can use for the Division Sigil. Its main purpose is making unstable ingots, and we can use those unstable ingots for all kinds of really useful and awesome things. And we'll definitely be checking out what some of those things are all about, like, nifty things that we'll definitely be enjoying playing with. Ooh, sonar goggles. I like the sound of that. Oh, and definitely need to get ourselves a builder's wand. One of my favorites. All right, so we will be playing with some of the stuff that we've got right here pretty shortly after we've got this Division Sigil activated. So let's get to work. I know we need an enchanting table, and I might have a vanilla enchanting table somewhere around here. I do. I knew it. Haha. If we head out to a spot in the world, that might be a good place to do something. Let's find one. We're going to sneak out over here somewhere. We want to be far enough away from our base that we're not too close, but we also don't need to be, like, terribly far away. So let's find a spot that's not going to be too bad. Oh, what's happening? What's happening? Why am I getting dizzy? I can only assume something's gone wrong with my blood magic area. Why are you even not running at the moment? Let's activate the zombie spawner. Go, zombie spawner, go! Spawn zombies, please. There we go. Nice. That'll keep things going. I guess my life points drained. What ritual is running at the moment that would be causing my life points to drain? I don't think... Is this thing running? No. The lever's on, right? So this thing isn't running. Well, something must be running. I must have some ritual somewhere that I forgot existed. It happens. Alright guys, so I will be back in a few minutes. Let me pick out a nice location to call home, and we're going to activate this sigil. Oh, I remember what it probably is. It's my lava fountain down there in the Batania area. I forgot that these, I added more pools here. For a while I thought, oh, what, weren't these full? But that's right, I used a bunch of my mana, so probably my lava doing that. Alright, so let's pop up into a spot that will allow us to do some stuff. So we're going to need some redstone. I know we're going to need that. So let's just grab half a stack. We're also going to want a golden lasso of some kind. And we're going to want to snag some kind of animal with that golden lasso. We'll grab a sheep. You're with me, buddy. And away we go to the area where we're going to set this up. Now, trust me when I tell you, you're going to want to... I should probably snag my potions and everything before we actually activate this, so don't let me forget. I chose an area that's relatively far away from my base, but not too far. We're going to do it right about here. This looks good. And let's get our enchantment table down. And if you right-click with the Division Sigil, shift right-click, that is, Altar does not have a redstone circle. That's the first exclamation point that we see as being a bad problem. So let's put a redstone circle around the altar. And altar has a circle placed on dirt. That's correct. It needs to be on dirt. Altar can see the moon. That's right. It has to be outside, even though the moon's not out. Sufficient amount of natural earth nearby. And the only other thing we have to do, altar must not be lit by outside sources. What outside sources are lighting the altar? I mean, it's daytime, but that doesn't count, surely, right? I guess we'll see what happens when it's nighttime, but I assume that that means there's some kind of torch or something nearby. Oh yeah, it's definitely dark enough out here. Well, we'll see what happens when it's nighttime. Let's actually make it nighttime. What I'm going to do is snag my vials that I made last episode. So we're going to want strength, fortitude, sure, shielding, mending, and revitalization. We'll want to have those guys on hand and ready. And while I'm here about things I've got on hand and ready, let's put some stuff away that we don't really need at the moment. Like you guys, and you, and the redstone can go away. So, let's make it nighttime. Speaking of, how's my soul network doing? Did it start filling up yet? If it did, well, I'm not dizzy, so that's a good sign. Yeah, 28,000? I'm good. Nighttime! So now let's just make sure that that light message is gone. And if it is, we should be ready to roll. Out and about to get this activated and ready. Altar is in darkness. Cool. All right, so it's outside sources, I guess, included the sun. So the sky is showing us that it's not quite midnight yet, and that's what we need to wait for. Once the moon is completely at the top of the sky, it's going to be midnight, and I believe that the division sigil is going to start glowing. And at that point, we have to release the sheep from this golden lasso and kill it on top of the enchantment table. And that sacrifice is going to activate the division sigil, and it's also going to convert all the dirt nearby into cursed earth, which is awesome yet terrifying stuff. You really don't want to have a ton of that nearby at pretty much any given time. So I'm going to be prepared. I'm definitely going to want protective stuff. So we'll want shielding and absorption and fortitude. Those will be probably the things I'm going to want. And I'll use two there, so that'll be good. So this will activate. I'll have a bow in case too many monsters get any bright ideas. Take them out. And I've got my iron excavator here, which will be responsible for digging up cursed earth because it does need silk touch. And I've got the three potions I'll drink. Regen, shielding, and fortitude. And that should be pretty good. Cool. So once the moon's at the top of the sky here, I will come back and we'll get ready to run this thing. All right, guys, it looks like we're getting close here. Again, the trick is to look straight up, as far up as you can, and if you can't look up any further, that, when the moon gets to that point, is going to be midnight. Ah. Sneaky zombie. Activation ritual failure. Too early. Yeah, zombies work too, by the way. I just learned that. I knew you could probably kill anything, but I just want to make sure no other monsters, because we're about to get a lot of monsters here. I'm not going to lie. Looks like we should be almost at the point where this activation ritual will be ready. There it is. All right. So if we shift right click, perform the sacrifice. So I will drop the sheep here and dun, 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 dun. So I should warn you that cursed earth monsters are really quite nasty. I hate these cats as it is. All right, I'm running away. Ah! Wither cat killed me. Not good. Let's get some kind of weapon here. And I could probably use a pick, too. All right, so that wasn't beautifully executed, I'll be honest. But, oh well. What are you going to do? Let's fly over there, just to speed it up, so you guys don't have to wait for me to slowly walk across from point A to point B. Luckily, I'm kind of far enough away from that stuff that I should be able to sneak into my corpse and not have to deal too much with the problem. So I died over here near where the wither cats and such are. Gotcha. Nice. All right, you go away, armor on. Whoa, that fallen knight hurt. Alright, let's try that again. Fallen knights hurt as it is. So any mobs spawned by cursed earth are significantly more powerful and more deadly as a result. Now I do have until daytime to start harvesting that cursed earth. I've gotten a good amount of it, so I'm actually kind of pleased about that. Hopefully most of my items that I didn't get last time around are still floating around here. That's a good sign. What do I got in here that I can use against this guy? It's just equal trade wand. Yeah, my bound blade. Sure, why not? Gotcha. Cool. All right. Get my baubles back on here. And I think we're back to being pretty good shape. Cool. All right. And I'll put this and this away. Yeah, like I said, they hurt quite a bit. Let's drink some more potions. Alright, now we're a little bit more prepared for this. Let's get our shovel back on. And get over there with a few more things. What I should probably also have is a good bow. Where is my bow? There we go. And we'll do this. Good, I've got 30 cursed earth so far, so that's a good sign. You can already see these guys and how fast they run. But luckily, I've got an awesome bow. To be fair, I probably have enough cursed earth right now, but I wouldn't mind a few more pieces. There is a lot of stuff spawning there. Holy cow. How much do I have now? I have a stack of cursed earth. I think that'll do. Gotcha. Alright, let's head back to our base. The sun's coming up. When cursed earth is exposed to sunlight, it will light on fire and get destroyed. But since we've got a stack or so of it, I'm not worried about that. All right, to home we go. All right, guys, we made it back to our base. I've got a nice amount of cursed earth, which is good. We can always activate another ritual, so anytime we kill a wither, we'll probably get an unactivated sigil. If we ever need more than a stack of cursed earth, which I heavily doubt, we could actually just handle that by taking care of the wither. The first thing I'm going to do is show you guys how to make unstable ingots. Now, unstable ingots are dangerous. When you create an unstable ingot, which is taken an iron ingot and dividing by diamond, you wind up with an unstable ingot, which is highly unstable and will explode after 10 seconds. Within those 10 seconds, you have time to craft with it. After those 10 seconds, it'll explode and kill you and you'll lose the ingot. So you pretty much have to be totally ready, and you have to craft it in a vanilla crafting table. And I think the crafting station counts, so that should be good. So let's take a look. We're gonna craft a particularly good item right now. Oh, not even the crafting station works? Curses. All right, so crafting table it is. Wood, like so. All right, I thought I could do it in the crafting station, but apparently not. All right, we'll put this there for the time being. Okay, you ready? So iron, diamond, there we go. Unstable ingot. You ready? So this is how we're gonna craft this thing. One, two, like so. We're going to pull this out of there, and you'll see that they're turning red as they're getting close to exploding. And if you mouse over, you'll see that they're about to explode. Yoink! Got it out just in time. I crafted my first unstable ingot item, Angel Wings. Hooray! Angel Wings allow you to fly. Nice. So no more having to shift into bat mode and having to worry about, you know, how crazy morph can be. I'm going to go ahead and be able to fly around without having to worry about losing health or anything like that. Free unlimited flight. I love it. So Angel Wings, definitely not a bad thing. Of course, it did cost the one nether star that I had, but I feel like that was the good first use of my nether star, right? You can't go wrong with that. Nice, so our soul network's filling up. That's good to know. Let's go ahead and start using our awesome and fun stuff that we got ready. So what I'd like to have here is another grinder. So let's make one of those. And a couple other things that we're gonna need for this build. I've come up with a cool idea for what I think will make a really nice looking build, but I just have to implement it. So let's get another grinder and a couple other things. I'll come back once I've got most of what I need. All right, guys, the next thing I'd like to get my hands on is called a builder's wand. Ooh, fancy time. This luckily only requires one of these fancy divide by diamond ingots, so I get to show you a little bit more about how they work. So when you'll notice that when you mouse over it, it does give you that 10-second timer until it explodes. We'll go ahead and craft this with the obsidian to get our builder's wand. This is another extremely useful device. What it allows you to do is if you have a bunch of blocks in the world that you want to replicate their design, like so, you can simply use the builder's wand and note that I have some tiering in my inventory, right? And it'll show you a little bit of a, you know, overlay here of where these blocks are going to be placed. And when you right click with the builder's wand, it'll use the tiering from my inventory and place it in the world. How nice is that? So it makes building things a lot easier, especially when you're doing like large scale builds like this. So like right now, this thing was what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 across. So I just need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 more of these. And I might want there to be one extra barrier here. Like I might want it to be 2 gaps in between. So I just threw that extra line in there. So see how easy it is to build with a builder's wand? It's awesome. Do keep in mind though, like you want to pay attention to where these things are going to go. Like if you built it right here, it would be like that. I think if you hold shift, it'll stick to one plane. So like notice here, it's like that. I hold shift and then it's acting like that. So pretty cool. It's a little tricky to get the hang of. Sometimes you can't exactly do it. So go ahead and just place down like how you want your build to be. And it'll work. We can expand this out a little bit like so. And then come over here and 1, 2, cool. Good stuff. Okay, back in a minute. All right, so I think I mentioned last episode this was going to be a temporary build setup, and it is. So yay, I wasn't lying. What I wouldn't mind having here, and I'm gonna see, I might not need these carpenter's blocks around in here anymore, but I'll still want them on the outside, but we'll see how we want this design to work out. I'll tweak what's going on in the middle here, probably in a bit. Let's tweak it now, actually, because I am. Yeah, I know what I'm gonna do with this. We're gonna have something similar, but let's see, where's my wand of equal trade that I've been playing with? Sweet. That looks good. I moved the tank, obviously, too, that I had in here. So we're going to want to fill in this guy. And that doesn't look terrible. All right, let's sleep through the night, and then we'll come back. All right, I want you guys to see that I'm making some subtle changes to the way this thing was designed. I'm going to snag from my AE network. If my thing has a range out here, it should. That's where I got my dolly and some things from. Let's grab some more conduits while I'm in here. We're gonna get you, you, and you. Sweet. Item and pressurized fluid. Okay, so we'll hook these guys in here and here. And we'll also have the power conduits going in here and here. And we want to make sure that the items are in extract mode, always active. The liquid is in extract mode, always active. And the power is in in-out mode. And the same here. Extract, always active. Liquid is in extract, always active. And in-out mode for power. Cool. And then we can run the power line up here a little bit. So we'll want power running off in this direction. Probably actually don't need power here. Well, might stick with the fluid, but the power can just come right up the back here. And this is all going to be actually hidden internally. So we'll do that. We can now cover this up with Tyrion, and we'll probably put a conduit facade just to make it look nice. But Tyrion, and conduit facade. And we'll want actually the same thing here for fluid. So before I facade that up, let's do that with fluid. There we go. So fluids get pulled out of both of the grinders by way of mob essence, and they'll be pumped over to the mob spawner thing over there. And we'll also have a tank somewhere that stores like excess mob essence, and we'll get that set up in a bit. And that's where that piping will go. Cool. So then we can put the conduit here, facade, and that thing, and we're looking pretty good. And that's actually going to be hidden behind a wall of Pure Tyrion. So how does this look? We've got this thing set up. This is going to be our mob grinding area. So we'll have on the left here the mob spawner that allows you to choose what mobs get hooked up and put in the world. And this thing will be a Cursed Earth mob spawner, which I haven't configured yet, but I will shortly. We're going to put Cursed Earth in here and allow mobs to spawn to generate mob essence. And that's what the grinder is going to do here. So randomly generated mobs for Cursed Earth versus auto spawner using mob essence. Nice. The other thing we're going to want in this room, by the way, is a light. So let's get ourselves some kind of lamp. That'll work. Let's see. Whoops, that's not how you spell lamp. Dire wolf. White lamp from nuclear control. Project red illumination. This might do. I think I just want a normal lamp, though, and for that I can use redstone, right? Yeah, normal white lamp. I would like to test real quick with a lever. And while I'm here, let's get some conduit as well. I would like the insulated redstone conduit. Do I have redstone alloy as a auto-crafting thing? Not yet. All right, that's right. I said I needed to make more of this stuff, didn't I? I think it's, what, silicon and redstone? Let's put away the dolly. I don't need that anymore. And you can alloy smelter. All right, that'll cook up, and I'll get the lever piece temporarily, just lighten this thing up. I want to see with the F7 mode, if I throw a light right there, is that enough to light up the room? Not as bright as I would have liked it to be. That's not good. All right, so this looks like it'll do. These two lamps here look pretty good in the ceiling. And yeah, that looks sharp actually. So this is going to not be Cursed Earth. The Cursed Earth will be from this line back. So we'll do like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to simulate where the Cursed Earth will be. Okay, so let me actually dig that all out now. Okay. Looking good. And for now, I'm going to fill that up with dirt. And where's my wand? See how handy this thing is? Told you. It's the best. All right. And then this will be a drawbridge door, very similar to this drawbridge door. So we can get rid of this stuff. And this will be Cursed Earth. Daylight will destroy Cursed Earth. So instead of having a door of clear glass like that, I don't think there's any reason that we would ever want to go into that room. I'm trying to decide if there is. I might want to have just one little bit. Let's see if we have dark glass. Let's see if we have dark ethereal glass. Yeah, that's what I want. I want dark ethereal glass. All right, guys, time to do a little dividing by diamond. So you remember dark glass? This is a cool bit of substance that allows you to block sunlight, basically, right? So let's combine this with ethereal glass, which I'm about to make a little bit of right now. So in order to get ethereal glass, you're going to need an unstable ingot. So ethereal glass is really cool. There's two versions of it. There is normal ethereal glass. 8 glass around an unstable ingot gives you 4 ethereal glass, or the same can be done with dark glass. Awesome. So let's go ahead and make this thing right now, and we'll check it out. So we'll put these in here, and you go dark ethereal glass. Sweet. I'm going to try 2 of these. Man, my inventory is cruising full of fullness. Let me just put a couple things away real quick. Goodness, I almost need everything I have. Shouldn't need you, or you anymore. Okay, much better. Let's try that again. We'll do half of these at a time. So, boom. Cool. That's kind of a good way to go about it. Boom. Dark glass around. 1, 2. Perfect. That should be the amount of ethereal glass that I need for this room. So we're not going to have a drawbridge that goes up and down because it's rare that we're going to want to get in there. And if we opened the drawbridge, then sunlight would get in, and sunlight can destroy cursed earth, like we mentioned earlier. So we're going to place dark ethereal glass down. This stuff is awesome. So what makes ethereal glass different from normal glass or dark glass is that ethereal glass players can walk through. Hey, look at that. No problemo. But monsters cannot. So players can walk through ethereal glass, monsters cannot, and the same goes for dark ethereal glass. The only difference being, of course, that when we turn off the lights in here, the dark ethereal glass, it's actually dark enough to spawn monsters. In theory, some light's leaking in somewhere. Where is that coming from? Where would a light source be? Is it up here? Is this a light? Is white lamps? Oh, I think it's the white lamps. Well, that would not be ideal. Oh, yeah, now it's dark. Okay, good to know. So white lamps are bleeding light in here. That's not ideal at all. Let's find a different light source then. Okay, now that's not fair. They were just bleeding light in, right? Or is that, like, just me being completely crazy? If that becomes a problem, we might have to change that later. Okay, see, they're bleeding light in again. Weird. So when you turn on and off a Project Red lamp, for some reason, it becomes transparent enough that light can get through it. All right, that is something I learned new today. You guys get to see Direwolf learn new things. Let's find a different light source. We'll be back in a minute once I figure out what I want to use. All right, guys, I decided to go with lights from Ender.io. Lights from Ender.io are crafted pretty easily. It's just any kind of glass with glowstone and iron gets you light. There's also a powered light, which I wanted to mention briefly. It's obviously more expensive. It lights a larger area, but it does require power, as you could probably get based on the fact that it's named powered light. There's also a wireless powered light that can also light a large area, but can respond to a wireless charger. So if you have a wireless charger, you can light up your base with these things pretty well. But for now, this will do. So all I need to do is give them a redstone signal, courtesy of some conduits and such. So let's do that real quick. I'm going to, for now, run this up on the top here and configure this thing. Hopefully I'm in the right spot. Let's do this. To the left and right of the hole is where we want to configure the down to be in and out, strong signal. Down, in and out, strong signal. And I might hide that inside some facades, but I think I had issues with facades in that room letting light leak through, and we really want to be careful not to let that happen. So we'll have to just manage that in a minute here. But for now, we'll have the lever be down here. So where do we want the lever to be? Probably right here. Now, can I put a lever on a facade? That's a good question. All right, guys, you ready to try this out? Here goes nothing. Nice, look at that. How cool, huh? So that is a facade right there that, you know, the redstone thing is on. So levers can go on facades, and it works beautifully. I like it. So let's get this Tyrian covered up here. Nope, wrong thing. Looking good. And maybe I'll just hide this stuff like so or something. We'll get to it eventually. I'll cover up the rest in a bit. Or I'm going to try it inside and I'll let you know if it works or not. So for now, this works. So we'll have a regular mob spawner in there for now. Let's get some cursed earth. And let's see, is there something else I might want to make? We'll see. All right, so the good thing about cursed earth is it spreads like grass. All we need to do is place a few in here, and it will spread the rest of the way through, which is why I wasn't too concerned with having, you know, a lot of it. So let's see, is this thing getting power and running? It is. Let's get ourselves a watering can and get ready to step out of here when, you know, the time occurs. Can I water this thing? I think it needs to be dark for the watering can and for the spreading of stuff. Whoa, hello, there we go. Hey, yeah, it spread. See how quickly it spreads? Nice. So you, Mob Essence, do your thing. We'll turn the lights on for a second. So that should kill the mobs with the MFR grinder and suck Mob Essence into this thing. Oh, you know what? It's probably going to get jammed. Yeah, it's backlogged because there's nowhere for it to put the items. Temporarily, I'm going to set this up just to get us going. Did I put my dolly away? And we'll do the, what is that, south? We'll be in insert mode. There we go. So that should now kill things. In a moment. There it goes. Nice. And you can also see Mob Essence building up in the portable tank, which, again, is a temporary thing. We'll probably have a larger Mob Essence setup, but we'll get to that in a bit. For now, let's get ourselves a little bit more Cursed Earth, courtesy of the watering can. Nice. Look at that. Pretty cool, right? These guys can kind of see me, but you can see they can't make their way out of there. Also, watering can causes the cursed earth to tick faster, therefore spawning monsters faster, so keep that in mind. they will spawn relatively quickly, though. Don't worry about it. Nice. Look at that. There they go. So that is our Mob Essence generator. Now, we do have more work to do on this system, but not much. I do want to have a better storage system for portable for the Mob Essence, so an 8K tank is not going to work for now. But we do have the lights on and off system. We will let the grinder run all the time, so we're not going to worry about this thing getting turned off. I don't mind if that's constantly running. We can probably turn off F7 here, and the building looks halfway decent. I'm going to make it a little bit fancier, too, before we finish up. There's one or two things I want to set up with this before we're done with the build, so we'll come back next episode and finalize this thing. But for now, it's unfortunately time to wrap up. So this is Direwolf20 signing off. Hope you guys have enjoyed the episode. There we go, fully cursed earth. It was bothering me that there was dirt there, and I assumed it would bother some of you guys too, so I wanted to finish it. Direwolf20 signing off. Hope you enjoyed the episode. Mob Essence via Cursed Earth Farm up and running. By the way, yes, we will eventually set up some Cursed Earth in this room so that we don't have to constantly use power for zombie generation. Cool, right? I thought you guys might like that plan. It seemed like a good one. All right, take it easy, guys.